What is up? This is Arlington and I just landed right now. I'm like refilling the chemicals for the second truck. I just did took it to get an oil change. And not gonna lie to you guys, man, it's already like probably 6 months, 5 months in with the second truck, and I'm telling you right now, there's a lot of good pros, but there's a few cons, and that's gonna be a whole nother different video that I have to be discussing, because I gotta show y'all the information if y'all thinking about getting a second truck. But today, that's not what we're gonna be discussing. Today we're gonna be discussing 3 mistakes I made when the agricultural department made the inspection on me. So before I proceed with the 3 mistakes, I want to give you a little bit of the background. They call me, they're like, hey, it's time to do your pest control inspection. This is the agriculture department. We were wondering if we can go Thursday. They call me like a week before my appointment, right? So they told me, hey, we can go Thursday morning to your home, to this address that you have on file. And then I'm like, yeah, sure, that's fine. But they call me like in a really busy season. And I call them back. I'm like, hey, is it okay if we can push it like a day forward so I can be ready too? Because I was kind of freaking out. I'm like, dang, I need to have all my paperwork, I need to have all the chemicals like aligned, you know, like just making sure I have all my shit together, right? Because I ain't trying to lose my license, I'm trying to keep prospering regardless of the circumstances. Like, I gotta keep going, right? So right now I'm unlocking my chemicals. So before I proceed with the 3 mistakes, there's one minor mistake. I'm not gonna include it as a mistake because they didn't really write me up for it. They just gave me a verbal warning. It's, I don't know if you can notice already what's the mistake. No, y'all don't notice. I mean, if y'all do, then you got a good eye. But is this can right here, didn't really have a label. It slipped off, to be honest. It's an old can. And when she saw that, she's like, hey, that needs to be labeled. But since that was the only can that wasn't labeled, so she just pretty much just gave me a verbal warning. You know, she didn't really write me up for it. So that's why I'm not gonna count it as a mistake. But y'all should know that y'all should have all y'all's chemicals labeled. I even separated the dry and the wet chemicals, but they don't really check on that. I thought they did, but I still did it anyway. You have to, it's better to be safe than sorry, right? So, but now let's proceed with the 3 mistakes. That was just a minor mistake. So y'all can be prepared whenever agriculture department pulls up on you. All right, so for the first mistake I made, is whenever you're writing invoices, you know, you have to put chemicals on there and, you know, how much you use and everything. But this minor detail that they gave, written me up for it, and I even told them, like, man, this is the third violation. Like, you guys don't want me to make it. I even said it like that. I jokingly said it, like, man, you guys don't want me to make it in life. And they giggle and they're like, oh, no, it's just like a slap on the wrist. It might be just like a slap on the wrist. You might not get a fee at all. Anybody in my mind, I'm like, man, but I ain't trying to be under radar, like, for all these violations. So that was like my third violation, but I mentioned it as my first one because it's like a minor detail, it's a minor mistake. So whenever you're posting the chemicals on your invoices, make sure you put all the target pests. In other words, what I did, the mistake I made, is that I put general maintenance, like, under target pests. I just put general maintenance. I was too lazy to just put roaches, crickets, ants, spiders, scorpions, you know all the pests that I'm targeting. So I just put general maintenance. Like, some customers, they just want to be on a preventative plan, that they just want to have a general maintenance. I kept handing giving them the invoices, and they're checking each invoice. And, you know, most invoices I had the target pests, which is like the roaches, ants, crickets, all that. But one of them, they caught me off guard. One of them, I didn't put the target pest in. I just put general maintenance. So that fucked me up. So if you ever get audit, make sure you have the past 24 months invoices printed so you can hand it to them. Because I had to email them the rest, because they asked me for like 8 at that time, or 10 actually, if I'm not mistaken. It's because this was the inspection, the audit was like a month ago. So it's kind of like, I'm kind of washing, it's kind of washing away, you know. So make sure you have the past 24 months invoices printed, like just one of each month. You don't have to print all the invoices. Some people, there was a CEU that I was doing, and there's a guy on there that said, oh, I have all my invoices printed just in case I ever get audited for the past 24 months. And I'm like, yeah, I'm not doing that. It's not because I'm lazy. No, I'm like lazy. It's not that. It's just, you know, trees. Like, I don't know. I care about nature. Like, why are we gonna print so much paper? And they're not even gonna see through the whole thing, you know. So now that I know, like, how much they want to see, it's just one invoice of each month for the past 24 months, and make sure it's not the same customer. So that's a good tip, advice for anyone that's getting audited. So make sure you do that, and not just that, but make sure you have the pest listed and the chemical listed. That's required by law. And then I thought you had to have the weather on there. I remember I asked, and you don't have to have the weather on there, because I remember when I was working at Terminix, we had to have the weather. All right, so the second mistake, or the second violation I made with the agriculture department, is
it's not completing my CEU. What does a CEU mean? It means continuing education unit. Having CEUs completed every year, it shows the state that you are up to date with the new laws, along with the fact that you're refreshed with any old current law. These can be completed virtually or in person. Also, please be aware that if you do decide to take any virtual classes for the year, you have to make sure that the next following year you're taking your classes in person. If not, the Texas Agriculture Department will not accept it. In other words, you can only take virtual classes every other year. So how did I mess up? Well, I started my pest control business in July 2021. So many pest control owners told me that my first year in business is waived off. However, I was not aware they meant calendar year and not fiscal year. Therefore, my CEUs were waived off for the year 2021, but were due for the year 2022.
All right, third reason, or third mistake, third violation I made is it's pretty much the first topic that they talked about, that these two ladies came in and told me pretty much why they came to audit me, is because my license came out as delinquent. In other words, I was pretty this close. They told me I was this close on pretty much just starting all over again. I'm not sure that they meant as an apprentice and up, or just retaking the whole business license test and getting the whole business license number. But they told me that the reason why is because I didn't have insurance on file. And I'm like, oh, I definitely do. And I'm like, I've been paying for that every month. And I showed them, and they saw the policy effective day and the expiration. They saw that it's active. So they're like, oh, okay, well, it's a common mistake that other pest controllers make. And they say that don't stress about it too much. But I make that next time, I make sure that with my insurance agent, they're renewing it. When every time I renew it, I tell them to submit this, the ALS 1101 form. So when you're first starting out your business, and when you're renewing your insurance agent, your insurance policy, make sure y'all are submitting this so y'all's license is active. Once y'all do that, y'all be fine. Y'all be good to go. I even talked to another pest control owner. He told me he was 20 years deep, and one of the years he forgot, or he... Yeah, he pretty much forgot to tell his insurance agent to submit the ALS form. So it's a common mistake. So don't stress about it too much. But learn from me, because this is one of my favorite quotes. Let me see if I can find it. I just had it up. Right. Always try to learn from other people's mistakes, not your own. It's much cheaper that way. So in other words, I want to suffer the consequences of paying, like, let's see, I probably might pay $300. Or $750. I'm looking at the table. So if you ever wonder, like, once you get audited, and like, let's say they write you up for something, like for something minor, like, you know, it could have been, you know, you forgot to label your backpack or pump. And by the way, I remember I did that. I made sure all my chemicals were dry, like all the dry chemicals and the wet chemicals were separated. Everything was labeled, like on my truck, everything was locked up. I made sure everything was good, but they didn't even check my truck. So, but it's always good to be safe than sorry, you know. So I made sure everything was ready, but they never checked the truck, which I was kind of surprised, but it's fine with me. But like I said, you might, it's always good to learn from other people's mistakes, because you don't have to suffer the consequences of me paying.
So it got cut off. I Yeah. I was right now editing the YouTube video, and I'm like, man, I'm trying to go to sleep, and I can't believe I cut off. So, but this is what I was trying to show in that previous video, previous clip, is the table. So look it up. In Texas, it's called, you know, Texas Department of Agriculture Structural Pest Control Service penalty matrix. So it can give you an idea of, like, if you ever wonder, like, okay, like, I just got pulled over for this, or I got audited for this certain violation. You can look up to see, like, where's your price range. Sometimes it's a warning. Sometimes it can start as low as $150, or it could be as low or as high as $2,000 for your first violation. But the good thing is that they give you pretty much three chances. After pretty much the third one is where you get suspended, and that's where we don't want to be. I don't want to be there. I hope y'all are not there too either. Like, I hope y'all get awake with the first or at least second violation. Yeah, that's pretty much it. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe, because I'm out here trying to do good with my YouTube content. I know I'm improving. My recent YouTube videos are getting better. I'm putting subtitles. I'm doing the most. I'm editing a lot. So please give it a thumbs up. Or if you're new, please just subscribe. That's all I'm asking for.